life transformation strategist and super life navigator. Welcome to Mid Talks. Mid Talks brings to you the best practices from people who have mastered their navigation and who are sailing through the ups and downs of their lives skillfully. Today I have with me Janvi. Hi Janvi, Chitalia, and she's a nutritionist. She studied nutrition from UK. Welcome Janvi. I'm so happy that you could make it over here.
It's my pleasure to be here.
Janvi, as I mentioned, Mid Talks or My Inner Direction Talks. We talk about the best practices of what people use within their lives.
Correct.
So I would like to know, where do you get your strength from?
I think the most important part of having the kind of strength that you need inside you comes from your self-belief.
Okay.
And I think it's something that you need to kind of, it's like, you know, how you do as a workout, or you do, it's like a spiritual workout that you do every day to go a little deeper inside and understand more about what you really believe in yourself and whether you need to condition yourself to do some certain things the way you need to do them. So I think it's a repetitive process of trying to understand yourself deep within that draws the strength. You know, so I really feel that when I think about you know, any situation, I always find it easier to kind of go back and look at it in terms of, also in terms of somebody, you know, as a direction, as per your thing, that okay, what would be important for me to do if I was in a situation like that. Also to be able to put yourself into a situation like that, especially to even help out other people that you're normally doing, it helps me to draw the strength to be really, really honest, look deep within and find the answers and keep doing that again and again to keep drawing strength from my life.
So, looking within, is that the only way that you find your answers? I mean, how much do you have to look within, or do you meditate, or how do you look within? Is there a process to look within?
So, definitely I'm sure there are a lot of processes in place to do that. People find comfort in doing different things. I've been a practitioner of Buddhism for a very, very long time, and I'm practicing Nichiren Daishonin and Buddhism. And what I really believe is that what they say in the philosophy is that you know your inner strength is all that there is. Everything that you need is inside you. And when you chant, you're able to manifest the kind of Buddha potential that you really want in your life. And that's what wells up the courage, the wisdom and the strength to come forward. So that's something that I've been practicing for a really long time right now, about 5 to 6 years, and I've seen that as I've done that, I've seen a real change. And whenever I'm in a dilemma, or wherever I feel like I'm getting stuck, or where I feel like it's a moment of weakness, I find it always easier to go back there. So maybe any kind of a meditation or a kind of system where you can actually engage your inner core is going to help you draw that strength and whatever you feel most comfortable with.
Okay, so what we've seen, we've interviewed a number of people who are, according to me, master navigators. And the first thing that they say is that we look within.
Right.
Now, normally, 99% of the time, people are, not willing to look within. They're always looking outside for some excuse or the other, that because of that one, my thing didn't happen, or I could not do what I wanted to do. So what is it that makes a person want to look within?
I think first of all, it's very important to understand that looking inside is a matter of first of acceptance, of understanding whether something, is not only going wrong outside or in your external circumstances, but also being able to be having the courage or the strength to say that, or even the awareness to say that, you know what, hey, let me look inside and see what needs to, what I need to change, or what I need to really look at, just apart from looking at what I see outside. So I think it's very, very important a lot of times to, have that kind of a direction and see if that really makes you realize that there is much more than you can, tell by the naked eye. We tend to very easily be in our comfort zone and say, this is not about me, it's about everybody else. And it's a tough thing to do, but it's, again, I think it's a matter of practice. About sitting down, trying to analyze, trying to again say that, let me try and be honest with myself. I think, and honesty and integrity become a very important part of looking within. So I think, it's practice and it's being honest with yourself sometimes and really asking yourself whether what you're saying is, do you really believe that it's only about others or is it about yourself? Questioning yourself becomes important to be able to start looking within.
So when you say questioning yourself, does it imply that you're doubting yourself?
No, so when you're questioning yourself, you're not doubting yourself literally in that sense, but it's obviously, you know, where obviously any question starts with wanting to know more or, you know, wanting to go further. So it's about starting with a proposition where you're saying that, you know, maybe I can take this moment off and think that, you know what, I don't have to always be right or I don't have to always know everything, and to give yourself that chance to not be that, you know, correct or perfect person every time. So that doesn't necessarily have to mean that it's a doubt. But it's something that you can do to question yourself, because it's a way to kind of improvise and learn further. So you can look at it as something that you want to do to kind of grow, you know. So
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's break it down. Let's break down that process a bit further. Supposing a situation has happened which has hurt you, how would you internalize it and go through the process which you just mentioned?
Right. So I think if there is a situation where I feel that I have been hurt, first of all, I think I would let myself feel what I feel. It's important to acknowledge and not just to put another carpet and say, hey, you know what, it's okay, because that's what actually clogs up inside and creates a lot of other internal insecurities or damages inside emotionally. So it's important to, at that point in time, sit down and first of all acknowledge. And then after you've acknowledged and you've let that anger or that hurt or guilt or whatever that emotion is that you're feeling very strongly at that point in time, you have kind of managed to kind of have that under control, you may want to actually sit down and analyze the situation in terms of whatever has happened. So I would typically want to kind of feel what I need to feel, and then when I'm in a better moment, a while after that, I want to really sit down and be honest with myself as per, and break the situation down and see where, you know, was I really, really, you know, correct in being that upset or feeling that hurt? What was the circumstance under which the other person? So being able to, as they also say in Buddhism, being able to see the Buddha or being compassionate towards the other person in the situation also is something which is really important, because at the end of it, believing that each person really has the potential to be a genuinely nice person is very important for you to believe. And you can only believe that when you believe that you can be that person yourself.
Okay.
So I think, you know, eventually it's about really sitting down and looking at the situation, which I would definitely do. And then maybe go back and say, hey, you know what, maybe I want to keep this in mind the next time a situation like this happens. I may want to see whether I want to react in that same way or change the way that I feel. And also be able to really, really draw as much compassion for the other person in the situation, understanding that there could be times the person is coming out of a, you know, situation or saying something because they also are dealing with their own issues inside.
Mm-hmm.
So really giving somebody that kind of a, you know, a compassionate angle is what I would say is very important, and that's what I would do.
Great. So we have a couple of things coming out over here from Janvi. It's that first is to look within, to take a situation and to allow yourself to feel the pain or whatever emotion you're feeling at that time. And then you, once you've gotten the emotions out of your way, then you kind of sit back and analyze whether it was worth it or was it justified to feel that emotion, or how better she can control her emotion or her feelings at that particular point when, if suppose the situation comes again, right?
Yes,
so,
absolutely.
So this is a huge lesson we have learned from Janvi. Would you like to share anything with my audience over here?
Also, I think something that I would really like to talk about is, you know, I think it's very important to find that one thing, you know, that one, either a practice, either a philosophy, a way of life, something that really makes you feel that you can anchor onto it in the times of where you really feel that, okay, you know what, I know I have a lot of family members, I have a lot of friends, but sometimes you need that external push, you know, which you need from a philosophy that you can bank upon, read, and something that you can eventually over the years learn to internalize. So when you're absolutely looking at practicing something like that, that's when you're in a difficult situation, that's the first thing that will come to your mind, you know. So I think engaging into something that you really have faith in, a philosophy that will guide you at the times of difficulty or keep your head high even when you're happy and keep you in that life state, which keeps you happy, makes you feel that you have faith in every step that you're taking every day, is very, very important, because we all know that we all go through situations in life which are hard. There are days, and even if life is not, our situations are not hard. We have a bad day, we have a good day. It's something that all of us go through. So to keep us in a constant life state, it would be really, really important to take on to something which is more and over and above, and that's going to help you continuously look within and really, really recognize the potential that you have within while you're actually fighting a challenging situation, because there is so much more inside you than you know of really when you just look at it from the naked eye. And this only a process of going within or learning to go within through any philosophy is the only way you will actually learn to do that in the long run, and that will come to you naturally then.
Great, that was wonderful, and I'm positive that my audience has picked up a lot of important tips.
Yes.
Thank you so much for coming here. It's been a pleasure, and I hope to see you soon.
Absolutely, thank you so much for having me here. It was a pleasure to be here, and I hope whatever we shared today is really gonna add value to you people's lives. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
Pleasure.